Hi there,
this is Barbara Template, and today I'm going to show you how to use the new feature in Canva, tables. So let's start. I'm going to share my screen right now, and we go to Canva. So we open our Canva, open some new design, doesn't matter what kind of design is it, let's say Instagram post. And first, let's have a look where we can find tables. So I'm going to create a blank Instagram post. I'm just making it a little bit bigger so you can see it. Move myself a little bit over here. So where do we find tables? This feature wasn't available before, but now it's great, especially if you, for example, if you're a teacher, if you're using Canva for your work presentations, or actually any kind of the reason when you need to use tables, to have some kind of fancy tables. There's lots of functions you can do with tables. So we go over here, we go to elements, and when you're in elements, just you scroll down and you find the tables below the chart. So as you can see over here, tables, we click to see all of them. So you've got different type of tables that you can use. So let's say pick this one. Okay, so we just make it a little bit bigger. Like this. Okay, and so what we can do with these tables. So first, as you can see, when you click on it over here, you can change the color of the tables. Okay, here we have different shades of kind of peach color. So we can change to any color we like. Yes, oops, we don't want this one. So let's go back. So you can change the color of each cell within the table. Then when you click over here, you can set the border, the type of the border you want, same as in Excel. Yeah, like when you work in Excel, you can also change the color of the border, and you can also change the border weight. Yeah, how do you want the border weight to be thick? So let's change a color of it so we can see it better. Yeah, over here, as you can see, yellow. So we can change the border weight. Of course, you can change the font, the size of the text, and the color of the text. So if we click over here, let's try to write some text. Yeah, so as you can see, I've got the number 11. It's very small, but we can fit a lot of information there. So let's go for maybe 36. See how big is it? Yeah, there we go. Okay, so we can change the type of the font. We can change the color of the text. Let's go for blue, yeah, or black. So that's way how you can change whatever comes with the text. As you can see, when I'm in this cell, there's kind of three buttons on each side. So when I click on the button, I'll just move myself over here. Here we have some functions which we can do with the cells. We can delete the row, add a row before and after, move a row down. We can size the columns equally. We can size columns to content, and we can even animate it. Yeah. So you can actually use this tables in various ways. You can make really nice and fancy tables with different kind of table, or a different color of the cells, different color of the border, different width of the border, what is it called, weight, yeah. You can also do the different table spacing, and you can add or delete as many rows and columns as you like. You can animate the cell. Let's try to animate. I just click on this and let's try to animate. So then you've got all the options for animation. Yeah, as you can see, so you can create really interesting presentations with interesting tables You can make it transparent, of course. So plenty of options for you to do when you creating tables. And don't forget that you can, again, you can download it as an image. You can download it as an MP4 video, for example, when you animate it, or PDF print, or you can just send a link to your colleagues or students. And there's also one handy function which is in Canva, and that's when you go to uploads, and that's record yourself present. Yeah, so you can record yourself. Let's say you have some presentations where you are using your tables. And don't forget, we have also great charts or way to do iconographic in Canva. You can record yourself, or you can do a voiceover. So plenty of options how to make really interesting presentations or study material, some promotional material where you're using tables. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in next video. Bye-bye.